So hello, welcome to today's update video. This is gonna be a little bit shorter than yesterday, but shortly after the publication of yesterday morning's video, the National Hurricane Center designated upgrade Invest N1E into Tropical Storm Blanca, into Tropical Depression 2E, and earlier today pulled the trigger on declaring the depression. Tropical Storm Blanca, and it's actually undergoing currently a mid-grade tropical storm with winds of about 50 knots or 60 miles per hour, and a central pressure of about 998 millibars, and it's located a little bit, like 550 miles southwest of Manzanillo, New Mexico. And it's heading west-northwest. I can show the generic forecast track, and I'll just get rid of showing pictures and the forecast. This is a generic track, the current National Hurricane Center forecast track for the system. And honestly, the depression was initially, as a depression, the system initially started to develop some signs of a central dense overcast feature yesterday. However, the storm did take a little bit, the depression did take a little bit to get going. And initially, for a while, it seemed that there was a large feeder band, had a little bit of an odd structure, that there was a large feeder band that was previously, it's gone fizzled out, but there was a large feeder band that for a bit choked the inflow of the system and prevented serious intensification. Prevent serious intensification, cause a very disorganized satellite appearance, like the ASCAT. There's an ASCAT scatomometer overpass from about 23 hours ago now. Showed a very disorganized tropical system that barely had a closed center of circulation. But as of right now, the newly upgraded Blanc is doing a lot better. You can kind of see some fairly cold cloud tops. You can kind of see convection bursting near the center. You can kind of see some good well-established outflow channels, both equatorial and polarward outflow channels. And you can see the storm's definitely willing to take off. Now, let's take a look at the ASCAP pass from when the system was still a little bit disorganized. You can kind of see this, but this ASCAP has also, these 35 knot barbs are also initially prompted National Hurricane Center to declare this Blanca. Now, if you look at the satellite photos, the relatively recent, yeah, this is like as of 16 minutes ago, this is kind of satellite photo of Blanca. You can kind of see a nice small concentrated area of cold medium and cold dark grays from the deeper convection. You can kind of see the well-established cirrus alpha that I mentioned previously. You can kind of even see on the microwave imagery, you can kind of see there's some evidence that it's starting to develop a bit of an inner core. And given the improved organization since the 22.50Z microwave pass, you probably made further progress on the inner core since then. And if then this system can maintain inner core and not get interrupted by any dry air, which is somewhat of a challenge, just because it's located in a relatively unstable environment, you can kind of even see it. You can kind of see the signs of the stability if you're on the northern part of this image. And you can also see the cirrus. You can kind of see the marine layer on this part of the image. This is located in a relatively dry environment. It's not that much of a surprise for early June, but it's still a dry environment that's likely to at least somewhat limit at least long periods of intensification. So it's like to limit long periods of intensification. Long periods of intensification. In addition, there's also a displaced upper-level anticyclone because there's a ridge of high pressure located over Mexico, and it's located in a position that's not particularly conducive for intensification, and it's displaced upper-level anticyclone located in north, the system is likely to induce some moderate wind shear starting about 8 to 12 hours from now. So Blanca, if it's going to become a hurricane, it's got to do so relatively quickly. The latest Dvorak numbers, the latest Dvorak numbers are from SAB are T3.5, so the system doesn't have too much more to go. Has about 0.8 banding, and for hurricane strength on a log 10 spiral, you want about over 1.0 banding. So this Blanca does have it. So Blanca is not that far away from becoming a hurricane, but it doesn't have much time to do so either, as I mentioned previously. As it's going to start encountering some stable air, some wind shear, as I mentioned previously, and even slowly starting to encounter, as you can see in the ship's output, which I'll pull up in a second. As you can sort of see in the ship's output here, based on the interpolated energy forecast point, you can kind of see that sea surface temperatures are supposed to drop below 26.5 degrees Celsius in about 84 hours, and it's supposed to drop below 28 degrees in about between 36 to 48 hours. As a result, I think I'd be surprised if Blanca was still a tropical cyclone by the end of the week. Anyhow, before I wrap this video up, I want to mention one more thing. This is from the 0Z European run. The 12Z European run didn't have this, but the 0Z European run did. They started an additional tropical cyclone trying to form relatively far west for this time of year, at around 120 degrees west and 11 degrees north. An additional tropical cyclone trying to form. This could be our next tropical system after Blanca. We'll have to see. And read the Canadian model. The Canadian model is showing two distinct systems, but the GFS is not. They're trying to show one of those messy Central American Gaia systems. The development itself is, at least according to GFS, likely to not occur till around June 10th or June 11th. And, or beyond. And it's likely to be a system around in the Caribbean that will likely eventually shoot itself towards Texas or Louisiana and rather develop in the Eastern Pacific proper. Anyhow, that's it for today's video. Hope you guys enjoy this. Maybe I'll post something else in a few days. I may not. I may never post again. Bye-bye!